picture your favorite town, and now imagine that for some reason a volcano is erupting nearby, sending lava flows towards your favorite location, and you only have 72 hours to divert it. What exactly should you do? This situation has popped up all too frequently in recent history, where various methodologies have been attempted to divert lava flows which weigh many thousands of tons. You might think that diverting a lava flow is a simple task, as after all, I visited a successful dirt lava wall in person in Iceland at the Fagradalsfjall volcano in 2022. Or, in a more recent example which occurred earlier this month, dirt barriers successfully saved the majority of Iceland's 3,800-person town of Grindavik from being overrun by lava during an eruption of the Reykjanes volcano. Yet, these methods have been far from consistently successful, and even with the two most recent apparent success stories, there are notable failures which occurred. For example, during the 2021 Fagradalsfjall eruption, one dirt barrier failed and was subsequently completely covered in lava. Or, during the 2024 Reykjanes eruption, lava not only breached the dirt wall via a fissure erupting through and then on both sides of it, but also breached a separate section of the wall where minimal friction was present where it overlaid pavement. Before I discuss what methods and strategies can be used, I want to highlight the first example of a semi-successful lava flow diversion. For this, we need to head back in time 355 years to the year 1669 on the island of Sicily within Italy. There, an unusually voluminous flank eruption of a towering Mount Etna had begun on March 11th at a location 14.8 kilometers south of its summit. As the Monterosi cinder cone erupted lava at a high rate, it soon became apparent that there was a major problem. Lava was advancing at about a rate of 950 meters a day, and it would now only be a matter of time before it struck and likely destroyed the large city of Catania. Wanting to take action, a priest gathered 50 men armed with clubs and traveled to, although not known at the time, what happened to be a lava tube. They then all started whacking away at the top of the tube, collapsing a section of it and causing lava to temporarily cease moving towards Catania and instead divert to the southwest. There was only one problem. The residents of Paternò were now in the potential path of advancing lava, and angry at what the residents of Catania had done, they brawled with and then chased them away, causing the lava to eventually resume its original path. Another attempt to stop an advancing lava flow occurred during 1935 and 1942 at Mauna Loa in Hawaii, when military aircraft dropped 600-pound bombs on lava tubes hoping to cause lava to spill over at the blast site instead of heading downslope. Both attempts did not make any difference. Lava diversion attempts are only sometimes successful, but making an attempt is generally better than taking no action. Attempts which have met with some success have used one or more of three strategies. These are upstream diversion, downstream diversion, and stalling. Upstream diversion involves attempting to clog a lava tube fairly close to the erupting vent. Such an action is hoped to clog a lava tube, feeding a more distant lava flow, hopefully causing lava to spill out of the tube and flow in a new direction. In the modern day, this is usually performed by placing explosives on a lava flow and then detonating them from a safe distance. It has a mixed track record of success. Downstream diversion involves any attempt to divert lava at its tongue or furthest extent which is actively advancing. The most popular method is to build an earthen wall, but the wall must be taller than the advancing lava flow or it will have little chance of success. This method has a poor record of success as thousands of tons of molten rock will generally either eventually overtop the wall or break through an unseen weak point. However, taller and thicker walls, multi-layered defenses, and those which protect structures during a fairly brief eruption on flatter terrain have a higher rate of success. There is also another method which Icelandic locals semi-successfully employed during the 1973 eruption of the Eldfell cinder cone. Using hoses on shore and on boats, they sprayed advancing lava flows to cool them. This formed a sort of natural lava barrier which redirected some molten rock away from the harbor and some structures. The third method is stalling, which involves building a small depression for lava to flow into for a time, or redirecting lava into such an area. The hope being that this will temporarily stall an advancing lava flow for a period, allowing other methodologies to be attempted with additional bought time. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron Calone for supporting this channel on our Patreon page.